Good afternoon. My name is Erwin Vast, and I work at the Erasmus Medical Center in Rotterdam. So close to my office is the Erasmus Bridge in Rotterdam. Perhaps you have seen it before. And my presentation is also about the bridge. It is a bridge between two systems. So Transmart, which I assume you all know, and XNET, which is an imaging archive. So I'm a bit curious, so I have a question for you. So who of you knows about XNET or have used it before? Okay, about half, I would expect. So I have a short introduction for XNET, just to give you an impression of what XNET is and why we are using it. So I am working for the biomedical imaging group in Rotterdam, and we have a lot of images that come from the hospital. So I have three examples just to give you an impression. So I have for example, an image of a carotid artery in the neck with some calcification. I have an image of a person's brain and the heart of someone. And in our group, we have a lot of these images. We do a lot of population studies, also from medical centers in other parts of the Netherlands. And because we have so much images, we are using XNET now recently for storing these large amount of images in a structured way. So XNET is a web application. It can store all the patient images, for example, the brain here. It has a 3D viewer to view the images. And I will quickly show you a few slides from XNET just to give you an impression. So this is one server we have with XNET. We have a lot of images, a lot of projects. And if you go on a project, for example, this test sandbox project, we have a list of patients. And we have a list of sessions. So a session is each time a person goes through a scanner. And a patient can have multiple scans. For example, with population studies, one can have a scan at a specific time and one after a year. And for each subject, which is a patient, we can have the images shown with thumbnails, but also with the viewer that I've shown before. And another thing that is linked to the presentation, this presentation, is that in XNET we can also store a lot of variables. So the idea is, which are derived from images, so the idea is that we have these images in XNET, then we send all the images to a computing cluster, then we do some calculation, and then the results are stored back in XNET. So we have also we both store the images there and also the results. So I've shown you XNET, which stands for Extensible Neuroimaging Archive Toolkit, which is a platform developed by the Washington University. This neuroimaging is in the name, but it can essentially store all kinds of images, but we use it mostly for medical imaging. And we also use it for multicentric data. And I have one example for a brain here. So I have a brain, and from that, with certain algorithms, we can derive the amount of gray matter and white matter volume of a brain. So it's a certain kind of statistic or biomarker for the brain. It can say some things. And the question is now, why should we use Transmart? So I will conclude now with this part about XNET and move on with the coupling with the bridge. So the question is, why should we use Transmart? Well, we have an idea that we want to couple the imaging data that we have and the biomarkers that we have with genetic data. So this is a hypothetical use case. So for example, we have the genetic data, and we have the MR image here. And perhaps based on the population, for some people, perhaps we know that they have Alzheimer or not. We can perhaps find the classifier. So we can say, even perhaps before a patient has real significant complaints, that we can diagnose perhaps that someone has Alzheimer or not. So these are stored in XNet, and we think that Transmart is a good solution for to use the genetics data and other kinds of data to get to merge these data. Just to give you an overview of all the systems that we have, I have an architecture overview. So I have the DICOM images here that come from the scanner. Then we anonymize the data, so all data like the patient name and birth date, for example, are removed from images, so patient data is always anonymized in our studies. Then we store the images in XNet. Then we send the images to a computing cluster, which sends some results back, for example, the white and gray matter volume I showed you. And these data are sent into Transmart. And we have built a plugin in Transmart to retrieve the data from XNet. So we actually don't send it from XNet, but from Transmart, we retrieve the data from XNet. So the plugin consists of two parts. The first part so I have two images here. So what I would like to note is that on the left image, the data is shown in the ontology. Now this data here is data that is retrieved from XNet. So that is shown in the Transmart ontology. And we do that by a new panel. That is something we created in the administration panel. I will give you a short demonstration. And here we create a coupling between the Transmart and XNet system. So these variables describe which data to retrieve from XNet. So this I will describe this shortly. So in the first column we have the Transmart name that is shown in the ontology on the left side. The data type, which is very XNet specific, which says something about the location of the data. And this is also XNet specific, which is a link which describes which variable I want to retrieve. So if I want to create a new coupling, I can create such a configuration to say which data from XNet I want to store in Transmart. So in the administration panel of Transmart, perhaps you have seen it before, are some options, and we added a new option there, the import XNet clinical data. And we added some panels, so the user or administrator can create a new configuration, and each configuration describes which data to retrieve from XNet. So I have one example here. So it has a name, a description about the study, the web address of the XNet server, the username, the XNet project name, and the Transmart node name, which is shown in Transmart. And for security reasons, we don't store the password. We always ask the user for the password when one step before actually importing it. So we don't want to store the password in the database. So we create these configurations so we can have multiple configurations for Transmart. For each project, we can create a new configuration. This is the after filling it in. This is the same configuration you've seen before. So for each new variable, I can add a variable here and just add it to the list. And after I've created a configuration, after we have configured a configuration, we can import the data. So we ask the user for the password, and then we retrieve all the variables that we have described back in Transmart. And yeah, it can take a few minutes depending on the size of the data set. And after the import, all the data is shown in the ontology here, and we can create a lot of nice statistics in Transmart. And if, as you can see, we have like a duplicate here. We have baseline and follow-ups. So for each time a patient goes through a scanner for a study, we import all the data. So the coupling looks at in XNet which visits a patient has, and imports all these data. So we can also show the data. And what I would like to emphasize is we also added the link here, go to XNet. So for each patient, we can import the, sorry, for each patient, we can also directly go to the images. So this link links to the XNet for that specific patient images. So we can directly view the images outside of Transmer. So some details about how the coupling works. So we have the XNet server here. What we create is a plugin. This consists of the online configuration which I've shown, which is a Grills plugin. So actually we almost did not change anything in Transmart except the menu, which is part of the Transmart app. But the plugin itself is a separate plugin which can be separately installed. Then we have a script that consists of Python, which uses a specific library, PixNet. There's a Python library to retrieve data from XNet. And that creates all the importation files, data and mapping files that are used to the default ETL importer. So one specific use case that we have for this coupling is with the knees. So when we have one study we would like to do to use that is going to use this coupling. Is this we have image from the knee here, and we have a healthy part and an osteoporosis a patient that has osteoporosis in the Dutch bottom coupling. And we can see based on an MRI scan and some calculations that there is some deviation here. And the idea is to couple these images that we have with genetic data in Transmart and to check if there is a classifier, and perhaps if we can find such a classifier, we can perhaps diagnose patients or improve diagnosis or perhaps diagnose patients even before they have significant symptoms. So the plugin is an open source plugin. It is available via GitHub, and it's also a page on the wiki, the Transmart wiki, with more information, a lot of documentation, and also a link to GitHub. So if you want to have, like to view more information, you can also find it in the Transmart wiki. So to conclude this presentation, we have built a plugin to import image-derived data from XNet to Transmart. And we hope that we can correlate the images that we have and the imaging data with other kinds of data, like genetics data or the other kinds of data. So we hope that we have created a new bridge. And with that, I would like to conclude this presentation. And I'm happy to answer any questions that you have. Thank you. We had plans. I think last year we had a teleconference with the people that you mentioned, Imperial, yeah. And we had the idea to merge it, but so far it is not merged. But I think it is a good idea to look at each other's work and to compare it and to check if we can merge the things we have built.
Yeah, I would really favor that, and it seems to be rather trivial, but I don't know how to move it forward.
Yeah, I think they had the idea to be here, but they had other appointments. So it's like, I would like to discuss it, but they couldn't make it here. So I think it's best to discuss with them how we can merge this. Okay, yes, I
hey,
talked
so
to them. Yes.
I was already listening to you as well.
Yeah.
Maybe. So I think one of the issues that many people are are I think it'd be great to start with use case, right? And have use case drive integration rather than just saying, okay, let's put it together. That might be the best way of doing it. I'm not sure if we do the use case that exists right now, but says, okay, this is how we can sort of put these two SNAP integrations with maybe a slightly different focus around emphasis and maybe put them together, or maybe not put them together. I mean, it's kind of like one of those things that I've realized over the last few years, like not in the real world. In that real world, the ideal of the ideology of the human
any other questions? So the plugin is a great. The plugin that we created is so the most important thing for us was to have the import configurations that I've shown you to be available in the Transmart administration panel. So that's the most important part, I think, of the plugin. So all the administrators can create these configurations, can store them, and can reuse them if the data has to be updated, for example. So is that an answer for your question?
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. Any last question? Okay, thank you.
Thanks very much, everyone.
Hi. So, I hear this presentation. Okay. Well, on my thing, I was like, welcome.
Somehow flexing off.
More. Yeah. The post. Your network, I don't.